If someone is strolling down a busy city street in China, then they'll likely come across a handful of small barbershops. These hole-in-the-wall barbershops are decorated with pictures of colorful hairstyles and filled with an abundance of young staff members. Usually the staff looks like they're in their early 20s. The hair salons are often packed with these young employees who have experimental haircuts and super skinny pants and button-up shirts. It's not uncommon to see these characters with haircuts wider than their waist. It's expected the labor is super cheap for the haircut places. With such high unemployment figures for China's youth, it's not a surprise that the staff members are choosing to take on this tertiary profession instead of grinding work in a factory outside a city. In China, there are about 3 million hairdressing and cosmetic stores. There are also about 8,000 training institutions preparing people for the industry. And it's a very popular industry at that. The trend of focusing on fashionable haircuts in Asia is a huge industry already in Japan, Hong Kong, and Taiwan. Mainland China's is definitely influenced by such trends. Despite their obvious low wages and oftentimes poor living conditions, the sheer scale of the industry leaves many wondering how these stores stay in business. Typically, the actual haircuts only cost a few dollars, which shouldn't be enough to cover the fixed costs of salon supplies and those of labor. The biggest money maker for the hair salon is to sell prepaid cards to customers. This helps bring in cash needed to pay off debts and hold on to a customer base. Without prepaid cards, more expensive and fashionable equipment couldn't be bought to keep up with trends and quality standards. So these cards are seen as an essential part of the industry. Insiders expose that in general, an investment of over $163,000 can be made back in just a few months or at most in a year. The head of the East Top Hairdressing Company released that a hairdressing store, which takes up 5,400 square feet, calls for about $196,000 in a year. The cost of renovations can reach more than $490 per square meter. The prepaid rent and investment will total around $327,000. That means the store has to earn at least $49,000 each month to make ends meet. But if it sells prepaid cards, then the store can drastically cut down that time. Shanghai was the first city known for pushing prepaid card businesses at hair salons. This seemed like a sensible transition following the heavy use of credit cards within the city. The prepaid cards had widespread use and were considered rational comparison to a credit card, since prepaid cards gave discounts on prices and didn't charge interest. Wenfeng Hairdressing and Cosmetic Company Limited was the first company in Shanghai to try out the prepaid card business. In order to expand a chain of stores, Wenfeng tried to sell prepaid cards to consumers to raise funds. And it worked. By 2004, its branches grew to more than 100 stores. Many other hairdressing stores also began to follow suit. The soaring trend of prepaid cards has become even more severe. Chinese media released that for most of the hairdressing businesses, the sales of prepaid cards have accounted for more than 70% of all their revenues. Don't go away, because we'll continue to look at the cost of prepaid cards for haircuts. Stay tuned.